Okay, everybody, just a quick look at the next test that we're going to be taking. The beginning of it is quite basic. It says measure the each line segment to the nearest half inch. And what that means is, if you look at this line, it's obviously 1 inch, 2 inches. I'll move that down a little bit so you can see. 3 inches, 4 inches. And now when you're in between 4 and 5. So the only possible answers are 4, 4.5, or 5. And it's going to be which that line ends up closer to 4, just solid, 4.5, or 5. And in this case, it's 4.5. On this one, you're going to do the same thing. The answer, boy, it's right on 2. You're going to stay just straight up 2. That's that. Because the answers, let's see, the possible answers is just a little short of 2. So it could be 1, 1.5, or 2. And that's clearly 2. The last one takes us out between 5 and 6. Out here, the possible answers are 5, 5.5, or 6. And that's pretty clearly 5.5. Centimeters, same idea, same exact idea. We go like this. If you look at this, the possible answers are 9, 9.5, or 10. And that is pretty clearly, if you look at that, 9.5. And then on this one, you've got the same idea. The possible answers are 12. Let me get that more underneath the camera. Sorry about that. I got a little bit of a mess here. Possible answers are 12, 12.5, or 13. That clearly is 12.5. And then on the last one, if you look at this one for a second, it's between, oh, this is a real doozy, 3, 3.5, or 4. And I still would have to say that's just closer to 3.5. I mean, like, just kind of a tricky one. They want the perimeter of this rectangle. What you got to remember when you do the perimeter of a rectangle is that this is also 7, and this is 2. And I always think of it as like a little microman's going to go on a journey, and he's going to walk the outside of this. So 7, 2 and 7 is 9, and 2 and 7 is 9. 9 and 9 is 18. Same thing here. Microman is going to go on a little walk. Here's microman. Microman. You got 7 and 11 is 18. 18 and 18 is 36. And you could just, you know, 11, 11, 22, 22 and 14, 36. This is the trickiest one of them all because they leave this blank and they want the perimeter. They want you to fill in these lengths. Now, you got to be a bit of a carpenter for this because you got to draw an imaginary line like this. And this might take up you explanations. The length of this whole thing we know is 15, and we know that this length is 6. So to the dotted line, if it's 6 here, it's going to be 6 here to that dotted line. So we got to figure out what would that length be here. We know it's 15, and this length is 6. What's this length? Well, I'll give it a second here. I'll pause it. What do you think? Here we go. I'm going to answer it. That would be 9, this length, which makes that 9. And then you got to do the same thing here and say to yourself, I know that this is 9 feet. I know that this to the dotted line is 4. So what would this length, if this is 4 feet to here, and this total is 9 feet, what would be left here? I'll give you a second to think about that. It's actually 5. 5 moves over here. That would be this length. And now I'm not done. I've got to go back to this length, this length, this length, this length, this length, and this length to get the perimeter. That's 15, that's 30, that's 34, 34 and 9, 44, 43, 43, 48 feet around. Okay, and I'll pause through that to see if we can figure that out. The perimeter of a rectangle is 22 inches, and its length is 7. Well, what I know is if it's 22 inches all the way around, these two numbers need to add up to 11 because it's half of that. So this width has to be 4. That's going to be 4 because then I'm going to have a little, you know, I got to remember that's 4 and I got to remember that's 7, and that'll add up to my 22. Trapezoid has sides that measure 9 and 13 and two sides that measure 5. What is its perimeter? Well, they're just giving you 9 plus 13 plus 5 plus 5. And I'm just curious, what do you think that shape is? It's 10, 23, 23, 32, 32. If you said trapezoid, you're right. What that would look like is a long bottom, two very short sides of five, and then a shorter bottom, like top, 9, 5, 5, 13, a trapezoid. Thermometers can be a little tricky. This one's counting by ones. It's not that tricky. It goes 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52 degrees. This one, a same thing, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 73. Be sure to put in the degrees there, and you could even put in F for Fahrenheit if you want to be thorough. And then the last one here is a little bit tricky in the sense that they give you bigger thermometers, and this one isn't counting by ones, it's by twos. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 11. I would set 11 or 12. It looks a little short. I'd actually call that 11 maybe. This one counting by twos, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I put that right at 50. And then this one is always this trick, kids, because you got to do it. This side is Celsius and this side is Fahrenheit. And so it goes up. This is zero in Celsius. So this is a negative number and it's counting by twos. So it's negative 2, negative 4, negative 6. Negative 6 degrees Celsius. And on this side, it's counting by twos. And you'd go 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, or 21. I'd accept either for that, 20 or 21 degrees Fahrenheit. And we could talk about that for a little bit too, but they'll probably give you a double whammy like that. But anyway, that's it. We'll discuss it. We'll talk about it, kind of ins and outs of that, and lift people up.